I'm telling you, Hank, you get Dale, your friend Dale, with those fire ants, get right in
here. Dale!
Ah! Oh, man.
Dale, you went too far this time. Come back here. Come here. I'm going to kick your ass.
No. No.
I'm going to kick it harder if you don't come over here.
You shouldn't have fired me. You know what I'm like. I'm capable of any crazy thing.
But my lawn, Dale, you don't mess with a man's lawn.
I had no choice. I tried planting the ants in your driveway, but they didn't take. They couldn't bite through cement. They're weak, like me.
For example, put a sail on your car, call it a boat.
Hear that, Hank? Gribble's got a clever idea. Go get me a sail.
It's a stupid idea, Dad.
Well, excuse me, Hank. I guess I'm not as clever as you are. I mean, I could never think of a clever idea like switching the eye chart so your dad would fail that test.
Dang it, Dale.
Looks like we got ourselves a Benedict Arling. What do you got to say for yourself, boy?
Look, Dad, I did change that chart. I did it because I care about you. You should not be driving.
But he's a war hero, Hank. A world war hero. You should let him do whatever he wants.
Shut up, Dale.
Hey, I'm gonna borrow your drill.
Where's my mower?
Oh, so you want to know where your mower is?
Yes.
It ran out of gas down past the gas station. I'll help you pick it up tomorrow.
You're not touching my mower ever again. You left it out in the street where any weirdo could just rub up against it.
Hank, what would weirdos be doing near the gas station? What would weirdos be doing near the gas station? Hank, once I crawl in there, I want you to quickly cover the hole with the screen. That's the only way in and the only way out for the raccoon. Do not remove the screen. No matter how much I plead or beg you, do not remove the screen. Hank! Open the screen! For God's sakes, Hank, I'm begging you! Open the screen!
That's it. I'm taking off the screen.
You promised Dale you wouldn't.
That's enough. Dale, are you nuts?
You'll never put that creep back together. I mixed him in with two chairs and a toboggan.
You're next. I'm kicking your ass through that thing.
You wouldn't hit an unconscious man.
I think I'm gonna be sick.
Briefcase.
What the hell are you doing? Give it.
Pocket sand.
You took the wrong briefcase. Dang it, Dale.
Oh, thanks for the heads up. I still can't feel anything in the digit.
What's that?
Dale has no feeling in the finger you cut off.
Accidentally. You know, if you want, Bill Boomhauer, one of you guys can come stand over by me.
I'll wait till you pass that anger class. You cut Dale's finger off for digging a tunnel. I once made a vest out of your wife's underpants. I can't imagine what you'd do to me.
Come on, I wouldn't hurt you. You guys know I don't have a problem with anger. I have a problem with idiots.
Hold it right there. One more step and you'll have to move to a similar house a few blocks away.
I'm not done training, you idiot. Now get on that lawnmower and pretend you're the bull. Now.
Okay. Grr.
Is that all you got? Come on.
Hey!
My God, Hank's getting right in the bull's face.
I'll kick your fat bull ass. Come on.
Ow! You play too rough. I'm going home.
My shingles. Get down here right now.
Yeah, I bet it looks pretty damn majestic from down there. Now, I could only fit 34 stars, so pretend it's 1861, if you would.
I'm not messing around. I have proven I could kick your ass while standing on a ladder.
Hank, I didn't see you as a flag hater.
I'm not. You painted my entire goddang roof.
With the symbol of our amazing government.
Yeah, well, I don't want to talk about the government right now. I am so goddang tired of all the bureaucracy and red tape.
What'd you forget at the market?
Dale, there are dead squirrels sitting on my cottage cheese.
Don't blame me. Blame the city dump. They raise their fees, so I have to save up the carcasses in order to be economical.
Get them out, Dale.
I'm guessing you don't want this guy camping out in the freezer then, huh?
Dale Gribble?
Maybe. Who's asking?
Rusty Shackelford.
What?
It's me, Dale.
But that's impossible. Rusty died in third grade.
I didn't die. I moved. You need to stop using my name, Dale.
I am not using your name, and I am not Dale.
Come on, Dale. You're smoking the same brand of cigarettes you did in the third grade.
Get off my property, whoever I am! My Spring Harvest Classic! The jewel of my basket collection has been taken! My basket!
I'm sorry, Shug. To me, it's just a container to hold things.
Just a container? I'll tell you what this basket contains. Unconditional love. Would you like some soda, Basket? I would love some soda. Thanks, Dale. I love you.
Okay, Shug. Whatever you say. I just wish you wouldn't spend so much money on these things. Do you have any idea how expensive our bills are? Maybe you should think about getting another job.
Say, old top, that truck of yours is quite the gas guzzler. How many offsets can I put you down for?
You can put me down for kicking your ass. What kind of stupid goddang idea is this?
This is the perfect plan. Strickland agreed to let me plant the trees on some land he isn't using. Bobby and Joseph agreed to do the planting, and I agreed to take the money.
Buying carbon offsets isn't gonna fix Strickland's image. It's just cheating.
Who's to say what's cheating? Is Leonardo DiCaprio cheating when he offsets riding around in a private jet?
Yes.
Oh, Hank, you just don't get it.